Welcome to this edition of the State Dollar. Our guest today is Susie Layne and Janet Clarke. Thank you, ladies, for joining us today.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Great. Can you tell us a little bit about your positions and what company you're with?
Sure. I'm with AARP Foundation here in West Virginia. We have an office here. Not every state has a foundation office, so we're pretty fortunate here in West Virginia to have an office here.
And I just recently transferred from the West Virginia Department of Health and Human Resources, where I was with the Adult Services Policy Unit, specifically for Adult Protective Services, and went to the Bureau of Senior Services.
So both of you ladies work for seniors, mm-hmm. trying to help seniors. So this project seems like a natural fit. Can you tell me how you got involved with it, though?
Mm-hmm. It's a worldwide event that every June the 15th, there is recognition of World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. And 4 years ago, when we first started, we put together a unique team of individuals. The past 3 years, we have had our event at the state capitol. Mm-hmm. And so this year, we decided to do something a little bit more ambitious. And to get to our target population, we decided that even though West Virginia World Elder Abuse Awareness Day is on a Saturday this year for June the 15th, we decided to hold it that day anyway, and it's going to be held at the Charleston Town Center Mall.
Now, before we get into the event, let's take a step back. What is elder abuse?
Well, elder abuse comes in many different forms. It can be financial, it can be emotional, it could be spiritual, it can take sexual, psychological, it can take on a lot of forms. And unfortunately, in West Virginia, it does go on here in West Virginia.
Last year alone, Adult Protective Services received 14,775 referrals on abuse, neglect, and exploitation.
Wow.
And as Janet mentioned, exploitation can involve many factors. And usually when you have exploitation, you also have neglect or abuse because the senior's needs are not being met.
So men or women, who is most likely to get abused?
Oh, it's the same across the board. I know that typically an average person would probably think that it is the female that would be abused. But men are just as vulnerable as what a female is to being abused, neglected, and exploited. So it runs gamut across both groups.
And you know, it also could be a family member, but then again, it doesn't have to be a family member. It could be a caregiver. And a lot of things that we've seen, you know, a lot of our seniors are isolated, they're lonely. And if somebody wants to come to their door and talk to them about and befriend them and have, that could be the first conversation they've had in maybe even a couple of days, or someone calls them on the phone. Again, it could be the first communication that they've had with someone, so they're vulnerable, they're excited, they need that personal touch, and then there's the scammer or the abuser waiting to make them their next victim.
And how that works is that you'll have someone that notices an elder that is struggling in the community. And they may be visiting, they may be out on the lookout for someone that is vulnerable. And they will ingratiate themselves to that individual by offering to get them their groceries, taking them to the doctor, and making themselves part as almost like a family member. And before you know it, that senior is already entailed in a scam of financial exploitation, and all of a sudden they're not going to their doctor appointments. And that's where the community needs to kind of kick in, because if you see your senior person that has always been part of a house of worship, part of community outings, community centers, has always been part of a group, and all of a sudden they're not showing up for these events, and it's been some while. And when you call and you're told that individual is no longer, you know, they're not available, they're asleep, they're at the store, then when that happens repeatedly, there's something going on, and that's when it's best, if you have any doubts at all, to make a referral and a report to Adult Protective Services in the county in which you live. Now, you can do that by looking up your county Department of Health and Human Resources number, or you can call the 1-800-352-6513 number. That will take referrals 24 hours a day.
So who are we inviting to this year's event?
It's open to the public. We want everyone to come. And like Susie had mentioned, it's mm-hmm. at the Town Center Mall this year, so we're real excited about that. We're going to have fun. We're trying to make it awareness, so we're trying to get people's attention. And I think this year we have some surprises, and I think it will get their attention.
Okay, let's talk maybe a little bit about the surprises. What's different this year from last year's event?
Well, this year, the Hansford Senior Center is going to start us off. And we can't tell you exactly what's going on with them, but they have been working really hard, and it is a surprise, and people will enjoy it. Then after the Hansford Senior Center, then we're going to have a fashion show, and it will involve a lot of our senior citizens, but it does not necessarily have to include all senior citizens. It's going to be a fun time. There will be refreshments afterwards. So we hope that people will come. It will be in the center court of the Charleston Town Center from 11 to 1. So we hope that people take advantage of the fact that we'll be there, and we're looking forward to seeing everyone.
Great.
We will also be, again this year, handing out the Ron Nestor Award. Mm-hmm. And that award is open to anyone who has, you know, been involved with promoting elder abuse, protecting seniors, volunteering their time to help with seniors. Mm-hmm. So the criteria for that is pretty large, and we will have applications being mailed out. They are due back in to me by May the 15th. So we're looking forward to seeing who this year's recipient is.
Great. Well, let's pause and take a brief look at last year's exciting event that was held here at the State Capitol.
Committed to protecting our seniors even further by introducing a seniors financial bill of rights. And now we'd like to welcome Ms. Becky Neal, Governor Thompson's Director of Intergovernmental Affairs. She will read the Elder Abuse Proclamation. I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out here today. On behalf of the Governor and the First Lady, I'm honored to be here with each and every one of you. We are all passionate about our seniors, and Governor Thompson wanted me to be sure and let you know the reasons why we are here today. It's because he believes that one of the most important things that our state government can be able to do is to protect our seniors. He also wanted me to take a brief moment to read a few remarks if you hadn't been here. This is exactly what he would be able to say to you. West Virginia is blessed with a variety of resources. We have millions of tons of coal, millions of acres of precious timber and rich wildlife, and hundreds of thousands of the most friendly folks on earth. Even with all of these great resources, you would like to say without hesitation that our seniors are one of our most precious resources. Senior citizens have collective wisdom. They've seen more, done more, and learned more than anyone else in our state. They must be protected. Governor Thompson wants each of you to know that he is committed to doing just that. In just the past couple of months, he has proposed and signed several bills that will directly affect our seniors, bills that will protect them. Beginning July 1st, our roadways will be much safer because his legislation makes it a crime to use a handheld cell phone while driving. His new substance abuse legislation works hard to rid our communities of illegal drugs, as well as prescription drug abuse, while ensuring those that who suffer with chronic pain remain able to receive their necessary medications. And rest assured, his administration is establishing an in-home care provider registry that will provide a dependable way to identify and research the backgrounds of the individuals who have been entrusted with the care and well-being of our loved ones. This registry is essential for safeguarding our seniors and it will provide their families with the peace of mind that they deserve. These are just a few examples of what Governor Tom has done for seniors in the recent months. He wants to assure each of you that he will continue doing everything possible to protect our seniors and their rights. And again, in his continuing efforts to protect our seniors, Governor Tomlin has issued a proclamation declaring today as World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. I'll have to put my glasses on and read this because the writing is very small. Whereas West Virginia seniors and disabled adults are valued members of society, and it is our collective responsibility to ensure they live safely and with dignity. And whereas combating abuse of older and disabled adults will help improve the quality of life for all seniors and disabled adults in this state, and will allow seniors and disabled adults to continue to live as independently as possible and contribute to the life and vibrancy of West Virginia. And whereas older and disabled West Virginians may be targets for abuse, neglect, and exploitation, which can occur in families and communities of all social, economic, racial, and ethnic backgrounds. And whereas during fiscal year 2011, the West Virginia Department of Health, Human Resources, Adult Protective Services Program received over 14,320 reports of adult abuse, neglect, and exploitation. And whereas in this endeavor, the West Virginia Department of Health and Human Resources Adult Protective Services Program works closely with public and private partners to serve our senior and disabled adults. And whereas the state of West Virginia and the Adult Protective Services Program of the West Virginia Department of Health and Human Resources are committed to protecting and providing for the needs of our older and disabled citizens through prevention assessments, investigation of reports, and arrangement of services. And whereas World Elder Abuse Awareness Day offers all West Virginians the opportunity to remember victims of adult abuse and their families, to promote the programs and organizations that serve them, and to participate in community efforts to improve the safety and well-being of all people throughout our state. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, Earl Ray Tomlin, Governor of the great state of
be with you today and to ask to offer a few brief remarks on this important occasion. This third annual West Virginia Elder Abuse Awareness Day in the halls of our state capitol is intended to enhance public awareness of the growing problems associated with the abuse, neglect, and exploitation of elder persons and communities throughout the Mountain State. To those organizations and individuals responsible for the sponsorship of this event, I congratulate you for your advocacy in bringing this important issue to the forefront of our attention. Although I am now a member of the West Virginia State Senate representing the legislative interests of the citizens of the 10th Senatorial District, I find that I have been indelibly imprinted and marked by my four terms or 16 years as sheriff of Bay County and my many years of daily work as a criminal justice practitioner. During that time, I can assure you that I have seen every conceivable form of human conduct and behavior in the world in which we live. While those of us within the field were conditioned to approach our sworn duties and professional responsibilities in a fundamentally fair, objective, and dispassionate manner, I always had great difficulty in maintaining such a judicious approach in dealing with those categories of crimes perpetrated against those who were truly most vulnerable or lacking in the capacity to defend themselves. From my perspective, those predatory crimes perpetrated against children, the elderly, or incapacitated persons were those that disturbed me most. As such, I would maintain that it is to these particular persons that we owe a high level of duty and responsibility to always protect. In our efforts to more effectively deal with growing problems of elder abuse and neglect in the state of West Virginia, matters of public policy and the content of our laws are most certainly important. In West Virginia, the message must be delivered and understood that in 2011, we had 14,320 suspected cases of abuse and neglect reported to our dedicated, yet underpaid, and under-resourced adult protective service workers called upon daily to validate these concerns. In sum, effective advocacy must be predicated upon facts and the building of public support for the passing of laws in the halls of the building in which we are assembled here today. For those looking for a cause, what a wonderful cause this can be. To speak for those who may no longer have a strong voice and a system they helped to create and hand it down to us and future generations. As a people, we owe it to our elders.
So I hear we have some special merchandise to give out to those who will participate.
Yes, we do. This year we have gray wristbands. They are embossed with purple to signify domestic violence. We chose that color as a committee because of the silver-haired legislators and because of the silver alert when a person has gone missing, an elder person. The wristbands say Stop Elder Abuse, and they have the 1-800-352-6513 number on them where you can call the hotline with any referral for abuse, neglect, and exploitation.
And finally, one last time, when and where is this year's event?
It's at the Charleston Town Center Mall on June the 15th. That's a Saturday from 11 to 1.
Okay. We want everyone to join us because you can't have enough out there, enough information out there about elder abuse. And so come and celebrate with us, and we will look forward to seeing everybody there.
Great. Well, thank you, ladies, so much for joining us, and we hope you have a wonderful event this year.
Thank you, Trace.